Isn't that a great video, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. What would you like most from the video?
The
jailer?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Almost killed himself, but then at the end he got saved.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome, huh? What about you, Sippy? What'd you like? The song part? You usually like the song parts. Yeah? Yeah? Well, they were having a rough day, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And the scriptures, they tell us about it. Before we read the scriptures, let's pray, okay? Lord, I pray that you'd help us today, God, to learn from your word. Lord, I pray you'd help me to teach your word. I pray for those that are watching, God, you'd help them to pay attention, Lord, that they might learn from your word, God, and learn what you have for them and the hope, Lord, that is in you. It's in Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen. You guys, now, they were having a bad day, and it tells us in Acts 16, 22 through 24, that they had been preaching the gospel and they're reaching people and things were going pretty well. But then healed this lady. They kicked the demon out of her and the people who were using her for money didn't like it. So they ordered some people to come and to beat them and to put them on the inner prison. Sippy, do you know what an inner prison is? It's the deep down depth of the prison. It's all yucky with rats. Kind of like a dungeon, yeah. There's like a cavern and like rocks and they're all yucky and stuff and there's rats in there and, you know, like people wearing old clothes forever and ever and ever. Ugh, it was yucky. They're having a rough day. Have you ever had a rough day?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what about you, Sippy?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Yeah, how did you respond to your rough day? Yeah, sometimes I feel like that. I'm like, at the end of my day. Well, they were having a rough day, but they responded in the right way. Let's look at what it says they did. Sippy, do you remember what they did right when they got locked in prison from the video? They did, but before they did that, they did something else. In Acts 16, 25 says, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed. They prayed. Praying is so important, huh, Sippy? It is. So notice first that they prayed, and Paul knew in 1 Thessalonians, he says, pray without ceasing. What does that mean to pray without ceasing, Luke? That's right, never stop praying. You gotta always pray because you have a God who always hears and always listens. What is this, Sippy? Jesus? It's a regular Sunday school answer. What is this? What is it?
A phone.
A phone, right? Huh. What can I do with my phone?
Call people,
right. But if you wanted to call me, can you call just anybody's number? Can you just put any number and press call? No, you have to call the right way, right? To the right one. So you gotta dial the right number. The Bible says, call unto me and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. Talking to God is a direct line between you and him. And you ask the Father in the name of the Son. Jesus says that no man comes unto the Father but by me. And when you go to him, you just talk to him like you're having a phone conversation because God listens to you just like anybody who you would call and listen. And the good part is he doesn't just send you the voicemail. He actually listens, right? He picks up and not only does he just listen, but he answers, right? So I noticed, what did you say they did, Sippy? Well, they prayed, which was super important. And on a rough day, go to God in prayer because he cares. And they sang, right? What did they sing? They sang, starts with a P. They sang praises, right, to God. And do you know in Psalm 119, it tells us that at midnight we'll sing praises. And that's exactly what they were doing. At midnight, they were singing praises. And they talked about, you know, I'm sure they sang about how good God is and that he deserves praise no matter what. In Psalm 100, verse 1 and 2, it says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with
singing.
Ah, good job. In Psalm 105, or 100, verse 5, it says, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. Well, them singing praises teach us a couple things. One, that they knew that God was good, even if their day was rough. And two, that they trusted God, that they had faith in him. The Bible says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, with everything you've got, and lean not into thine own understanding. It means don't just look at it in your own eyes. You may be having a rough day, but God may have a big plan for that rough day. So by his, trust him that by his grace, he will carry you through it. And by faith, you will see the victory. Finally, our last point here. Look at how God responded. Does anybody remember what happened at the end of the story? Something happened and everyone's...
Chains fell off.
What happened to the jail doors?
They flung open.
And they just ran for it, right, Selah? No, they just ran for it, sweetie. No, the Bible says that, and suddenly there was a great earthquake reminding us that God is in charge of everything, right? By him, all things consist. So that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately, means right away, all the doors were open, and everyone's bands were loose. And nobody left. The Bible tells us that the keeper of the prison ran in and he would have killed himself because he probably figured, well, he was going to be tortured or something for the prisoners escaping. But he runs in, he gets ready to harm himself. And Paul says one of the most beautiful things ever. He says, do thyself no harm, for we are all here. He says, they are all there. He says, don't hurt yourself. We didn't go anywhere. See, I believe that Paul and Silas had a testimony, but they wanted to keep good. And so they didn't want to run away. They wanted to face the issue. Face your issues. they face the difficulties. Thank you, sweetie. And not only did they not run away, but the other prisoners must have heard them praying, must have heard them praising God. And then when the guy came, he said, we're all here still. The guy looked at him, probably jaw dropped to the floor. If you were a prison guard, Lucas, would you expect everyone to stay in the prison if the doors flung open?
No.
No, I expect them to run off and go do whatever. Well, they didn't. They stayed there. And then the guy comes in and he goes to him and he says, sirs, what must I do to be saved? And Paul tells him, and they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house. And they spake unto him the word of the Lord, and to all that were in his house. And he took them the same hour of the night, and washed their stripes, and was baptized, he and all his straightway. And when he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them, and rejoiced, believing in God with all his house. Wow. They trusted God and God came through. And he showed them that their trouble wasn't just about them. Sometimes the trouble that we go through leads us to a point where we're able to better help somebody else. Always keep an eye out for what God has planned in the situation. And by his grace, you can be carried through. And by faith, you'll see the victory. Trust God and go to him in prayer. And remember to sing his praises, right? All right, guys, we'll see you next time. Bye. Make sure you go and check out the activities and do those with your family and just have a wonderful day. All right, we love you. Bye.
Bye.